What did that say to do?
Our daily changing. I am eternally grateful to have walked into the sanctuary today and see our normal, beautiful, outstanding Thanksgiving display. So for those Hampton United Church Fairies who gathered last night, thank you so much for bringing that sense of harvest and abundance into our worship time this morning as we continue to gather in a very different way. Some have gathered on Zoom with us, so welcome to those of you who've gathered by Zoom, and others will be watching this on video later. We have had the announcements showing during this Zoom time and for worship, but I will also offer announcements. Next Saturday, October 24th, we will be holding a cold plate harvest takeout. People need to have their orders in by this Friday, October 16th. As always, whatever we do here regarding food is fantastic. So the menu includes turkey, potato salad, cranberry sauce, coleslaw, dinner roll, and your choice of a homemade pie. So please remind others that the order deadline is this Friday, October 16th. And I know many of us are going to be here helping on the 24th and look forward to seeing people pick up that delicious meal. Today we are going to be celebrating communion. And when we had made the plan to do that, we had said for safety's sake, we would be inviting people to bring their own communion. So if you're watching by Zoom or by video, you might want to get some bread and juice, cracker, even your morning tea or coffee, and we'll celebrate communion with our ordinary elements. And what makes these elements holy is us being together in communion and remembering that banquet feast of Jesus and his disciples. I am continuing with the caring and connecting calls. If this is something that you'd be interested in, but Thursday mornings at 10 don't work, please just give me a call or call the office, because I can definitely look at different times to do that. On Sunday, November 1st, All Saints Sunday, that's when we will be having our annual service of remembrance. So as a congregation, we will be continuing that tradition. So please remember, if someone that you know has died this past year, you would like them honored in this service, please send their names into Kim. Depending on how many people we'll be honoring and how many might come, the possibility of doing the service, we might have a morning service at 10:15 and the same service at 7 o'clock if we have a number of people that want to come in person. If you have someone that you'd like to honor and you prefer to join us by Zoom, then we will be lighting the candle for you. And if Kim and her technology magic can do a virtual lighting, then we're going to try that too. We have some time to figure that stuff out. So please make sure you know that you let us know if there's someone that you would like to honor. And I think those are all the announcements. Anything that people feel I need to share that I've missed? So we gather as the people of God in this place. We gather on this Thanksgiving Sunday, remembering the abundance that is in our lives. And we light our Christ candle, reminding us that the light of Christ shines within us, around us, and through us. Our opening hymn is For the Fruit of All Creation, and remember, you can sing gently with your masks on.
Thank you.
Thanksgiving Sunday, our lives are warmed with smells of autumn and pumpkin spice. I myriad of pleasures colors our lives and turns our spirits to wondering about God's artistry in us. This harvest feast brings us to wonder the many ways we might give thanks, and how it is that God hears our thanks and praise. We are drawn to this place. The Spirit colors our lives with awe and gratitude. Come, let us worship God, and let us pray. God of grace, help us to remember. Help us to remember the times we have been blessed. Help us to recognize the gifts that fill our lives. God of grace, help us to be thankful. Open our lips in songs of praise and thanksgiving. Open our hearts in prayers steeped in deep gratitude. God of grace, help us to be generous. Move us to respond to your abundance by paying it forward. Move us to give from what we have to enrich the world around us. God, you call us to remember, to be thanks-filled, to be generous. Thanks be to you, O God, the giver and the gift, who challenges us to live lives of memory, gratitude, and generosity. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Our first scripture reading is from Deuteronomy chapter 8. For the Lord your God is bringing you into a good land, a land with flowing streams, with springs and underground waters welling up in valleys and hills, a land of wheat and barley, of vines and fig trees and pomegranates, a land of olive trees and honey, a land where you may eat bread without scarcity, where you will lack nothing, a land whose stones are iron and from whose hills you may mine copper. You shall eat your fill and bless the Lord your God for the good land that you have been given. So take care and do not forget the Lord your God by failing to keep his commandments, his statutes, which I am commanding you today. When you have eaten your fill and have built fine houses and live in them, and when your herds and flocks have multiplied, and your silver and gold is multiplied, and all that you have is multiplied, then do not exalt yourself forgetting the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery, who led you through the great and terrible wilderness, an arid wasteland with poisonous snakes and scorpions. God made water flow for you from the flint rock and fed you in the wilderness with manna that your ancestors did not know, to humble you and test you, and in the end to do you good. Do not say to yourself, my power and the might of my own hand has gotten me this wealth. But remember the Lord your God, for it is God who gives you power to get wealth, so that God may confirm his covenant that you have sworn to your ancestors, as God is doing today. And our New Testament lesson is from the Gospel according to Luke chapter 17. On the way to Jerusalem, Jesus was going through the region between Samaria and Galilee. As he entered a village, 10 lepers approached him. Keeping their distance, they called out, saying, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. And when Jesus saw them, he said to them, go and show yourselves to the priests. And as they went, they were made clean. Then one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, praising God with a loud voice. He kneeled at Jesus' feet and thanked him. He was a Samaritan. When Jesus asked, were not 10 made clean, but the other 9, where are they? Was none of them found to return and give praise to God, except this foreigner? Then Jesus said to the man, get up and go on your way. Your faith has made you well. Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of all of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. As we gather on this Thanksgiving weekend, we know that this year our gathering will look different than other years. We're not able to have all the family and friends around our table as we have in other times. We aren't able to travel to our loved ones who are outside our romantic bubble and be together. Family that we are missing dearly as we or they haven't been able to travel since March. We also acknowledge that there are those missing from our tables as they have died this year. Maybe it's the one who's cooked the dinner, or the one who carved the turkey. Maybe it's the one who's loved the mashed potatoes, or couldn't wait for the pumpkin pie to be served. We gather this Thanksgiving in grief. And the grief that surrounds us as individuals, as families, and as a society, as a whole right now, in the midst of this, we are still invited to pause, to give thanks. To give thanks for all that we have in our lives. Part of the healing process for grief is expressing gratitude. That's why sharing memories and offering a eulogy at a funeral is so necessary. So today, on Thanksgiving Sunday, as we acknowledge that we are 3/4 of the way through 2020, we are in a grieving process. And this weekend, we are called to be intentional in giving thanks, to really look within and to acknowledge all that we have been given, and then to look around and give thanks for all that we, as the people of God, can give to one another. Today's gospel lesson is about remembering to give thanks to God for the blessings we have received. 10 men were healed of leprosy by Jesus, yet only one returned to thank him. Now, those who had leprosy in Jesus' time were considered to be unclean and unwanted in society. They were felt to be a burden. They were alone, and they were afraid. Yet Jesus reaches out to these people. On the side of the road, these lepers call upon his name, and Jesus tells them, these diseased men, to go to the priests to be examined. The priests in Jesus' day would declare these men healed. So as they get up and go, all 10 are healed of their disease. But when one recognizes that he has been healed, he's the only one that returns to give thanks to Jesus. So what do we make of this? Does it mean that the others are not grateful? Does it not mean that the other 9 were not filled with joy? I'm sure the other 9 were just as thankful for the healing as the one who did return to Jesus, for they had all been given back their lives. Each of them could now return to their villages and care for their families. Not only were they healed physically, they were restored to their places in their communities. They were made whole by this wonderful gift of healing, and they had so much for which to be thankful. So why did the other 9 who were healed by Jesus not return to give Jesus thanks? The answer, I think, is that they simply forgot. They were so excited at this gift of healing and in such a hurry to share the good news that they forgot about the source of their joy, the giver of the gift. And maybe that's what's happened in our society as a whole. It seems many of us have such abundance that we are truly not in need. So we go about our lives in a hurry, and we often forget to give thanks for the gifts and the blessings we have. Throughout time, cultures have gathered to give thanks to God or the gods or their deities for the bounty they have received. And we need to take time and be intentional to live the blessings in every moment of our everyday. For me, I think that's one of the lessons this COVID time has brought, especially the time when we were in quarantine and isolated in our homes, away from family and friends and our regular activities. We have to remember in offering thanksgiving that in the sacred moments of our lives, God calls us to gather and to give thanks. We have not been able to gather in the same way. So as people of this church, as people of faith communities, as people in communities in general, we are called to gather and to celebrate and give thanks. In a church community, we welcome a child into our community of faith, and we celebrate the miracle of birth, and we gather as a community to grieve a death and celebrate a life lived. We gather in fellowship around a table for communion. Each of these rituals, activities, opportunities to give thanks looks quite different in these COVID times. Yet we're still called to gather in joy, to gather in sorrow, to gather for a feast that brings calm and solace to our beings. And there are times during this time when we feel, I felt it, that God is sometimes somehow absent. There are times when we might question God and even turn away from God. Yet I know and I believe that we can be assured that God's blessings still fall upon us. We might just need to turn towards God again and look for that. The book of Deuteronomy speaks of memory as being essential in recognizing and appreciating God's blessings. There's a Newfoundland saying, if your memory serves you well, we're going to meet again. If we hold on to the memories of the blessings, if we recount the ways we have known grace, we will truly know that we belong to a God who was and is and ever shall be with us. In our remembering, we can enter into thanksgiving and be a people who live God's blessing. And like that one leper, we can turn back and face Christ. We can recall and be full of thanks for joy-filled memories, for love shared, and for the ordinary moments of living, that we fall on our knees and give thanks to God. And when we do, it is at that moment that God will reach into our hearts and say, get up and go on your way. Your faith has made you well. And I think that's what so many of us need right now, to turn back and give thanks. As parts of our province turn back to the orange phase and the restrictions of gatherings, of activities, maybe we need to be mindful of acting with gratitude. We as a province have been safer than other places, but we can now see how quickly that can change if we are not careful, if we are not respecting public health guidelines. And as much as we feel restricted by wearing a mask or limiting our interactions, it is important that we do this for the overall health and well-being of others, ourselves, as well as the safety of our region. I hope from this time that most of us are living with a deeper sense of gratitude, having gone through the time of isolation in the winter and spring. We're fortunate to have had a beautiful summer with relatively few restrictions, which allowed us to give thanks to God for the bounty of the creation we have in this part of the world. And so we remember to turn to God with thankfulness, and that even when we forget about God, God does not forget about us. Even when we forget to return and give thanks, God does not forget to provide for our needs. So I think for Thanksgiving 2020, the message might be this. Through God's gifts to us, not only can we be made whole, we can have life in abundance. And yet while we often forget the source of all things and can fail to express gratitude to God for creating and sustaining our lives, we know from reading the Old Testament, when we hear Moses' words to his people, he recounts to the Israelites' experiences during their 40-year journey. And in order to be properly thankful, one must cultivate a good memory. Moses tells his people to remember the Lord's commandments and all that God has done and continues to do for Israel. In our experience of Christ, we know God's healing touch in our lives, and we know that God sustains us and provides us with an abundance of blessings. So as we give thanks this weekend for God's creation, for food and shelter, for the love and lives of friends and family, we must remember the love that we have always had and will continue to know. In Deuteronomy, we are reminded of God's actions throughout the history of the Israelite people. We are reminded that God was, has been, and is still with us. God has been present on the journey of the Hebrew people, and God is present with us in our journey. And when we offer thanksgiving to God for God's presence in our lives and give thanks for God's healing grace, it is our faith that makes us well. For Jesus said, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Do not let them be afraid." We know that this year in particular has been hard. Yet when we seem to forget the blessings in our lives and fail to give thanks, God does not abandon us. When everything is changing and we are hurting, isolated, stressed, confused, grieving, God remains with us. God's love abounds, and God's promise holds fast. So on this Thanksgiving weekend, if we remember that God has given us blessings which make us whole, then we too shall live abundantly. If our memory serves us well, we will continue to meet Christ at every turn, and it is then that we shall know true healing and true thanksgiving. To God be glory forever and ever. Amen. Our next hymn is "We Praise You, O God." To share our gifts for the work of Christ Church, our response to all we have received is gratitude and thanksgiving. So let us be thankful in our giving, the giving we offer to the Church of our time, our talents, and our treasure. For this is our faithful response. Let us give with gratitude and joy. Our morning offering will now be received. Created by you, God, purposed to life for you, to live for you, we daily offer ourselves in service. Receive these financial offerings here in our worship space, through PAR and through e-transfer. May they bless the ministry of our congregation. As you bless the people of this church, and the ministry of our congregation, and those whom our service and ministry reaches, here in our midst and throughout our country and our world, for our gifts and our gifts to the Mission and Service Fund. We give thanks to you, O Holy God. Amen. Sharing bread and the cup in communion reminds us of the forgiveness, love, and hope we experience through Jesus' life, death, and resurrection. Welcome to this time of breaking bread together, wherever you are. You are in the presence of God, and your table becomes the table where the feast of love is made. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Lift up your hearts. It is right to give God our thanks and praise. From the moment of creation, we have never been alone. Even when we don't know where to go or how to faithfully follow, God's grace waters and nourishes us wherever we are planted. When Abraham and Sarah left their home and their wealth behind, they trusted God's assurance of a covenant and a new home, journeying to the place God showed them. When Moses led his people from Egypt into the unknown, his sister Miriam danced with abandon and with joy at the possibilities. Throughout their 40-year sojourn into the wilderness, by trusting in God's grace, despite many challenges, the Israelites created a new home within God's heart. And when Ruth chose to accompany her mother-in-law and leave home, she placed her hopes and dreams into God's hands, pledging that home would be where her heart dwelt. So come, come before God, showered by God's grace, trusting in God's love within and among us. So we say, Holy, holy, holy Lord, power of life and love, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna through the ages. Blessed is the one who comes to bring your justice to earth. Despite God's unconditional assurances, despite our home within God's heart, despite our covenant relationship with God, we forgot who we were and whose we were. In response, Jesus came to return us to the path of self-giving love, to remind us of God's promises and of God's abundant grace. We remember that when Jesus ate with his friends, he took a loaf of bread, and after blessing it, he broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body given for you. Each time you do this, remember me." And then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, passed it to his friends, saying, "Drink. This cup that is poured out for you is the promise of God made in my blood. Whenever you drink it, remember me." In response, we sing of despair rising into hopeful anticipation, remembering Christ's death and celebrating the resurrection. We await with hope the coming again of compassion and justice to the earth. We invite the Holy Spirit to join us at this table. Bless us once more, loving Spirit, that as we gather around our tables, coffee tables, TV trays, kitchen tables, these tables become part of Christ's table, a place where we celebrate this feast of love and grace. In this time and in our own places and spaces, may we know your presence, O God, inside and out. Bless this juice and this bread as symbols of our home, that we may partake as family, strengthening our relationships by our actions. May your grace with us, your covenant of self-giving, so that we can fill us, so that we can dare to follow and serve you, entering fully into being your body and community in our world today. God, we pray that you bring the hopes and fears of humankind to this table and to the congregation of your people, those who seek to live and follow in Jesus' way. Let us be confident messengers of joy and offer a feast of tender kindness wherever the gospel is proclaimed. Let the Christ Spirit dwell here and everywhere, provoking the healing laughter that comes from being nourished in mind, body, and spirit. Let your grace amaze anyone who has given up on themselves, and come alongside all who are sick, struggling, and feeling without hope. Let us hold each other, our community, and our world in our prayers, as we pray the prayer that Jesus taught us. God, like a mother who gathers us close and comforts us, and like a father who calls us back home towards safety and protection, we pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Let us sing prayerfully as we gather at your table. Enjoy the feast of love, forgiveness, and grace. Thank you. And we pray our prayer after communion. Through communion with you, O Christ, we are made new. Through what we have said and done at this table, we have remembered your self-giving. Through your Spirit, we have been empowered in your name to go into the world to share your story. Thank you, O God, for the gift of such abundance. Amen. Our closing hymn is Joyful, Joyful, We Adore. We have listened. We have opened ourselves to God's presence. And now we go out to live as people who remember, who are thankful, who pledge to share God's gifts with the world, where we live and where we love. So may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us and go with us all this day and forevermore. Amen. Thank you.